Hi everybody, Kyle here with Black Lion Audio, and today we're discussing using the Revolution 6x6 with mobile devices such as Android and Apple phones and tablets for recording, as well as the OTG port and all the cool things that we can do with it. But before we talk about OTG, let's just talk about how to record with the Revolution 6x6 as an audio interface connected to your phone or tablet. Now, do note that the Revolution 6x6 is a class-compliant USB device, meaning it will work with most things that you plug it into. The first thing that we'll do is make sure that we're powering the unit with the 5-volt external power option. Now, we added this external power option to ensure that this unit will work with mobile devices, because while the Revolution 6x6 can be bus-powered by a computer, most tablets and phones do not put out enough power to power the unit. So we will connect the USB-C power cable to the 5-volt power in on the back of the Revolution and turn the power on. So now that the unit is powered on, we see that we have a blinking red USB indicator LED showing us that we are indeed getting power, but nothing is plugged in. So that's what we want to see. Now, before moving forward, there's a very important distinction we need to make between which port we connect the phone to. So if we are going to connect the phone or tablet to the Revolution 6x6 to record, and we're using a mobile application that's designed to work with audio interfaces such as GarageBand or BandLab or Cubasis that will allow us to choose the separate inputs on the device, we're going to make sure to use and connect our mobile devices to the USB to computer port and not the OTG port. I'll get into when we'll use the OTG port after this, but for now, we're going to connect our mobile device to the USB to computer port. So I'll connect my phone. I'm using an iPhone 15, so a typical USB-C cable will work. However, we do recommend OTG specific adapters or cables for most mobile devices. We'll put some in the description below. But I'll go ahead and connect the phone. And now that my phone is connected, we can see that the USB indicator is now solid green, showing us that we have a solid connection to the USB to computer port. And now if we bring up GarageBand or another application, we can see that we indeed do have access to inputs 1 through 6 on the Revolution 6x6. So now that we've gone over how to use the Revolution 6x6 as a traditional audio interface with mobile recording apps, now let's discuss OTG. So OTG stands for on-the-go technology, and it's designed to work with mobile devices, and it offers us a two-in, two-out stream from a mobile device to and from the Revolution 6x6. So that means that we can get stereo audio from the phone into our headphones, our monitors, and into our recording software. So if you have any virtual instruments on your phone or tablet and you want to record them straight into the DAW, you can do that through the OTG port. If you have some ideas in a voice memo, you can record that straight into the computer with the OTG port. Really, the possibilities are endless. Any audio on your phone can be accessed from the OTG. So let's look at an example of getting audio in from the phone, and then after we look at that, I'll show you some examples of sending a stereo audio stream out of the Revolution 6x6 and our computer into the phone. All right, so to demonstrate some things we can do with OTG to get audio from the phone into the Revolution 6x6, I have my laptop open, and now we'll connect things a little bit differently from before, and we're going to connect our computer to the USB to computer port, so I'll do that really quick. And now that the computer is connected to the USB to computer port, we can see that the USB indicator LED is solid green, showing us that there's a good connection for that port in the computer. And now we're going to connect our phone to the OTG port. And once we do that, the LED will turn yellow, showing us that we have a solid connection between OTG as well as the USB to computer port. The LED indicator will show green for USB to computer connected, yellow for USB computer and OTG connected, and it will be red, solid red, if there's only OTG connected. So now we can see we have a yellow light showing us that both our devices are connected. So let's say I have a virtual instrument, a piano, and I would like to rehearse or record the piano into the DAW. So I'll pull up the piano on the phone and I'll show you what to do in the DAW. We'll make sure that when we're in our recording software that we have a track armed with the OTG port selected. So you'll want to ensure that you have OTG 1 and 2 selected for a stereo input. And now we can see if I go to my phone and play my virtual instrument, it's coming directly in to Cubase. So super handy, super awesome functionality. And like I said, really can be used for many things other than virtual instruments to bring in audio from a phone. So your imagination really can go wild with that. Let us know in the comments below some ways that you're excited to use this. And before we move forward, I did want to mention that if your goal is to simply listen to the audio coming out of your mobile device and you're not concerned with recording, you can do that by putting the Revolution 6x6 in standalone mode. And what this does is it routes all of the audio from the OTG port directly to the monitor outputs. You can find more information on standalone mode in the recent video we published, and we can put the link for that in the description below. So now that we got that out of the way, let's talk about the next use case, which is sending audio from a computer out of the OTG port of the Revolution 6x6 into a phone. So what this is really useful for is sending high quality audio to apps that aren't really necessarily designed to work with an audio interface. So for example, in the beginning of the video, we showed how to connect the Revolution 6x6 to a mobile device to be used with an app that was designed to be used with an audio interface, such as GarageBand, where you can select all the inputs. Well, however, there are other apps that aren't designed to work with audio interfaces, such as Instagram Live. And if you've ever tried to connect an audio interface to Instagram Live while you're streaming or making a video, you'll realize that you can't access all of the inputs on your audio interface. Well, using the OTG port on the Revolution 6x6 can get you past that limitation by allowing us to set up a custom mix in our DAW on our computer and sending that out of the OTG port into the phone. So as I mentioned, that's super useful for streaming. You can also use it to send very high quality audio into the camera app. So let's say you use your phone to film cover videos of you playing guitar to a backing track, and you record the audio in your DAW, and then you record the video on your phone, and you have to edit those together. Well, by using the OTG port to send audio into the phone, you can bypass that extra step of editing completely and have the great sounding audio embedded into the phone itself. So let's take a look at an example of how to set that up. So for this demonstration, I'll be sending audio from the computer through the OTG port of the Revolution 6x6 into the phone for recording a guitar cover. So I have my guitar plugged into the first input, and I have a talkback mic in the second input of the Revolution 6x6, and our computer is connected to the USB to computer port, and our phone is connected to the OTG port. So we can see that the USB LED indicator is yellow, showing us that both sources are connected and that they are secure. So now let me show you what's going on in the DAW. Okay, so for this guitar cover, I have some bass stems, I have some drum stems, as well as my guitar track that I'll be recording with and the talkback track just in case I want it. So the first thing we'll do is make sure that we have our inputs routed correctly for the Revolution 6x6. So I'll bring up my inputs and we can see I have one named guitar here, and we made sure that was our mic line instrument 1 for our guitar, and our talkback mic is the mic line instrument 2 track. And those are selected on our inputs, so guitar and talkback. So that's good on that end. And now we need to set our output up correctly to send all of this audio to the OTG port so it hits the mobile device. So to do that, I'll make sure that we have an output bus set. So let's check. And I have one named iPhone, and we can see that I have out OTG out 1 and 2 as the outputs for the stereo out. So I've gone ahead and made a bus called main that all my audio is sent to, and that main output bus has my iPhone send going to the OTG outs. So now all my audio that plays through Cubase will go out of the OTG, out of the Revolution 6x6 into the phone. So since we're in a DAW, we can use whatever processing and plugins we'd like to use on our audio we're sending out to our stream or to our video. So in this case, I'm keeping it simple. I'm just using one instance of Gojira from Neural DSP to down pitch the guitar, another instance of the Gojira plugin for the guitar tone, and I'm using the Corniff Audio Amplified Instruments processor to filter and EQ the guitar a little bit. So let's go ahead and record some guitar. So those are some examples of using the OTG port on the Revolution 6x6 with a mobile device. I will mention that Windows users do have a standalone mixer that can be used with the Revolution 6x6 that includes a loopback driver. So there's a bunch of cool things that you can do with loopback in this situation that I'll be showing in another video. But if there's anything else that you guys would like to see from Black Lion Audio, please let me know and we'll be sure to get to it. Thanks.